This game's called Red Dead Redemption Undead Nightmare. We're going to be playing this. I'm going to try to make it long as possible today, because I'm just starting out into it.
Months away, John Marston has returned to his loved ones. While trying to rebuild his ranch and win back the trust of his family, Marston awaits whatever life will throw at him. As he drives home one evening from an errand, he ponders whether a man can ever escape his past. He is a man who is ready for anything.
Mother.
Oh, I'm sorry. I meant to say, damn this awful son I've raised with his highfalutin ways and his shame that his mother swears like a sailor and sews like a blind man. Is that better, your lordship?
Much better, mother dearest.
Oh, good. I'm so glad, my darling. When you've finished your university education and are far too good to even acknowledge my existence when we pass on the street, and you gently kick me aside and beg an old crow out of the way with your highly polished boot. Well, think of me kindly, at least, will you, my son?
I'll try to, Mother. I'll think, that woman I just kicked, that used to be my dear old potty mouth mom. Maybe I should bother to kick her harder.
Dear boy. Oh, I am so proud of you. Get off. Now, Father's here. Maybe he can beat some sense into you.
Something funny's going on out there. Damn dog's gone crazy, and wolves howling, and birds flying.
Well, it's just the storm, John.
Maybe. Uncle make it back yet?
I thought he was with you off drinking in the fields. I mean working, as you call it now.
He went into town a few hours ago after we busted that hammer working out in the meadow.
Well, he's probably holed up in some place of ill repute waiting for the passing of the storm.
I hope so.
Well, that old man can take care of himself.
I know. Just a funny feeling I got.
You called psychic, Paul?
Either that or I ate something funny. Knowing your mother's cooking seems more than likely. Mm.
Well, talking about food, who's ready for some poisoning?
Me, my darling. I am starving. What you reading?
Just some book about monsters.
Tell me about it.
It's kind of dumb.
That should suit me just fine.
Well, it's all about in ancient times how Aztec warriors worshiped the sun, but during full moons, some of them worshiped the moon instead, and upset the equilibrium of things. So anyway, what it involves is there's this one guy. He goes out in search of his own. So anyways, since there ain't no cure, the brave man has to kill everybody, which is...
absolutely disgusting and completely unbelievable. It's getting late. Guess we're not going to see Uncle till morning.
Come on then, Abigail. Jack, get yourself to bed, boy. Try to get some sleep.
Ain't you worried about Uncle?
Sure, but he'll have to wait till morning just like any other man would in his shoes. Good night, son. Don't stay up reading too late. You okay, old man? You don't look so good.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
To get my gun. Nobody puts their hands on my wife. I can't believe I had to kill that poor bastard. Well, you okay, darling? You okay?
Oh.
Abigail.
I don't feel so great.
Jack, get out here! Now!
Good Lord, what's happened? Mama?
Careful, boy.
Mama. Mama!
Stay right there, the pair of them. Don't make me no widower now. Stay there while I deal with your half-witted son. Pull yourself together, damn it! You've all gone crazy! What the hell's gotten into you? If you act like a child, I'll treat you like one. Into you sick, crazy bastards, or what Uncle's done to you, but I'm going to get help. Stay calm. As calm as you can, seeing as both of you seem to have gotten a little excited. Probably just a fever. Jack, be kind to your mother. Abigail, teach the boy right from wrong.
Okay.
Stop biting chunks out of people. Be back as soon as I can. Guess I best go find me a doctor in town.
Alright, before I start this episode, I'm gonna go to town, then I'm gonna go to the other towns down like then, get safe houses, and get better guns.
Is everyone.
Mr. Marston, sir! Marston! It's me!
Professor, what are you doing here? I thought you went back to Yale.
I did. I came back for another round of research.
Get some rest.
Thank you.
Anyone here? Hello? Anyone here?
Here, mister.
Come out. It's okay. Come out. I don't bite. Bad joke. I mean, come out.
They got my family, mister.
And mine, I fear.
I saw my mom rip my daddy's face off and drink his blood. And they were happily married 20 years.
I'm sorry.
We were so glad to see my mom. Because she's been dead for 3 years from the smallpox.
Your mama was dead?
I saw her walk up onto the porch. And then boom! She ate my daddy. You weren't a bad man, mister. You weren't. Sure, he liked to drink, but you weren't bad. And sure, he liked the company of women, but you weren't bad, mister. You weren't.
No one deserves to have their blood drunk.
I mean, he knew how to use his fist. And if a woman spoke out of her place, he reminded her of it and everything. And when my mama was dying, people said that he was lying with her sister. But that weren't true, mister. It weren't.
But you said your mother was dead.
Yeah, her and Mr. Braithwaite. He's been dead a year. And then yesterday, he walked up that street eating dogs. And he loves animals. All the dead folk have come back to life, mister. Only they ain't happy. It's a funny kind of salvation.
All the dead folk?
All the folk buried at the cemetery over by the churchyard.
My God. I'm gonna go have a look. You wanna come?
I already seen my mama. I don't need to see any more of my relatives. Here, mister. Take this. If you can burn them, maybe you can put their souls to rest. Mister! You see my Uncle Mordecai? Burn him. Burn him real good, you hear?
Thank you.
diluted you the first time you died. Not my day. This was a waste of time. Folks okay?
Oh, just fantastic. I just saw my daughter get eaten by some creature sent straight from hell. Thanks for asking.
I'm kind of sorry I did.
Sorry, mister. Forgive my wife. We've suffered terribly.
What's going on?
It's the government's fault.
Ain't it always?
Well, they let in too many foreigners. Just shut the goddamn border, or things like this happen. My daughter was just some satanic demon's lunch because of the goddamn government. I pay my taxes, usually.
I think we may be moving a little off topic here. I ain't a wise man, but I have done a little traveling. These creatures ain't like any foreigners I've ever seen.
Thanks for the input, cowpoke. Fleshy monsters feasting on my family, and I'm taking advice about tolerance from a gunslinger. What in the world has my life come to? And my daddy told me I never should have gotten married. This is all your fault, you useless man.
Oh, not now, Taureen. Not this again. Your daddy was a bully and a drunk.
Well, you ain't no kind of man.
Listen. I'm sorry to interrupt your happy reminiscences. Is there anything I can do to help? You got any idea of how we can survive?
You could try shooting them creatures, you dumb fool.
Ma'am, it's been a real pleasure. Sir, you're a man of great patience.
See? That feller ain't hiding away like a little girl who's wet herself.
I thought we agreed we should stick together.
So we're just gonna stay up here?
Hey, you one of them, mister?
Do I look like one of them?
Don't come no closer. We made that mistake before we lost half our number.
I ain't one of them, you fool.
Well, how do I know?
They can't speak.
I ain't taking no chances.
Kill him, he's one of them.
Yeah.
No, I ain't.
Don't take no chances, Silas.
Have it your way, all right? Listen, I ain't coming no closer. Do you know what's going on?
It's the glass eye. The freak with a glass eye, he caused this.
No, it's the snake oil man. These poor folks have been drugged.
I blame the Mexicans. They haven't been struck down.
All right, we heard a lot of stories, mister. Some say it's a moon. Some say it's drugs. Hey, don't come no closer now. Stand back. Apparently it's worse in New Austin. Must be where it came from.
It looks like I'm headed down to New Austin. Did one of you say snake oil?
It's the glass eye.
I blame the Mexicans.
Oh, Connie McTavish, you don't know nothing. You always was an ignorant shrew. I bet your husband's glad he's dead.
Well, at least my husband never took favors from the stargazers, Lucille Billingsgate.
You say you're sorry, you hillbilly white trash!
Yeah, yeah, now how are we gonna rebuild America like this? Now see, I thought we had it all decided. We was gonna be kind and gentle and pay homage to our leader, who happens to be me.
Sounds like you folks have this all worked out. Have yourself a fine America, and good luck.
We never had that decided. We decided we would hold elections and that I would be leader.
You can't even read.
Well, I got gravity. Well, I mean, gravy. I mean, folk respect me.
I am the new king, Archibald Andrews. Me. Now pay us.
Damn it!
by the way, in this town, we got this weapon right here. The sniper rifle. Or the repeater carbine.
Sorry, lady, about how things turned out. I don't believe it. Damn it to hell.
I shot my horse. No shit. Oh, well.
More than happy to rob you as well. More valuable than gold now.
jump over that? That's awesome. Here, you should be able to get a gun with a scope on it, like a sniper.
Oh, I got one, mister. Hey, I got one.
Got what, mister?
The damn Sasquatch. A filthy thing was going to eat my dog when this girl hollered out, and I shot the thing right through the heart.
Feeling all right, mister? I've seen a lot of strange things recently, but no Sasquatch running around here, nor no place else. They're made up.
There's Sasquatches every place, cowboy. They're nastier than your mother-in-law with a bad case of that virus. Down in Manzanita Post, they ate a little girl.
Are you serious?
Do I look like I'm joking? The hills are infested with them. Kill them! Kill the bastards before they kill all of us! Kill them! Kill them! I ain't afraid of you, you dumb hairy bastards!
Wait a minute, Midnight. You want to be on camera too?
Let's go! Whoa there.
There it is. It's a nice little sniper rifle. Oh, this, let's show you. There we go. Oh, we got a tomahawk from that one village. Awesome. Cliffs.
Whoa.
Oh, I'm up in this area. I'm gonna need these plants.
That's what I've been after.
Flowers, because I'm going to need them later on in the game here.
Hey, you! I hear tell there's a safe town nearby. Can you take me?
Yeah.
Get on! In a hurry!
Suppose I can, just to help you out.
Come on!
Send me a nation, guy.
I'll give you a quickie later.
You're welcome. Now get inside somewhere and board up the door. Come on. Thank you. Easy. Might as well. That's one. Let's go.
Foul creature of the night.
You're granting me peace.
Why's that? Keep you from eating more babies?
What in the name of all the traits are you talking about, human?
You eat babies. You have to survive. Everyone knows that. Ain't your fault.
We eat berries and mushrooms, you fool. But we did. Now none of us are left. Some maniac's been murdering us. I'm the last of my kind. We've lived in these hills 1,000 years.
You eat babies.
If you say so, human. That family is gone. My kind is gone.
See what I can do.
You are that bastard!
I'll cure him.
This is something I don't want to think about.
Give me another rifle. I can't remember what one it is. Right there. Or no, it ain't. It's that one right there.
Useless! God damn it! I knew it! Well, that didn't go well. Oh, shit.
Can you search that body or what? Apparently not. Oh, well, I can't get them all. Zero sniper at what?
Are we in hell?
Yeah.
I'll do what I can. There ain't much
of this. I'll follow him.
You're a lifesaver. Let you keep going.
Mercy on us!
kill you dead. I make you buzzard food.
Got it. I'm going to live with Jack Hillary, would you dare?
Thank you.
I don't believe it. About any of this. Good luck to you. Let's go. Carnage!
Kill a couple of those freaks for me.
least you can do after trying to eat me. You owe me, lady.
You turn up. Could my week get any worse?
Oh, nice to see you too, Miss McFarland.
Oh, I thought you'd be dead. I heard things were bad in West Elizabeth.
Sure. But it'll take more than an apocalypse to take me down.
What are you? A demon or a cockroach?
Both, I fear. How's your father?
Fine and dandy. He should be coming out of that barn any moment now.
What's he doing in the bar?
Daddy, John's here! Mr. Marston, you remember? That idiot bounty hunter.
What was he doing in the bar?
Just rounding up the undead and keeping them safe so the rest of us can go about our business. He's a real man. He's probably playing around with them. Daddy, stop teasing me! Now come on now!
How long's he been in there?
Not long. Only since yesterday.
Yesterday? I better go have a look for him.
Would you, John? You are kind. Call out to me if you find anything.
I will do. This curse if we don't band together. You don't need it, mister. Mr. McFarland, you were a good man. Bullshit! Abigail, Jack, the things I'd do for you. Ah, come on! Time for my pound of flesh. I knew it!
Well, John, you always do bring sunshine to my life.
I'm sorry about your father.
I'd like to say he died doing what he loved. But he never was one for eating folks, not slathering from the lips and howling at the moon. I guess I'll content myself with saying that he died protecting those he loved.
Indeed.
Well,
Take care of yourself, Bonnie.
You too, John.
Check out the weapons. Alright. Here's the first one. Got ammo for that. Don't have ammo for that. Only 2 rounds. Got ammo for that. Alright. Got ammo for that. Got ammo for that. And I got ammo for my revolver. Okay. I gotta work on to my challenges. Okay. Headshot 10. Undead in a row. Okay, I got that. Okay. Kill 100 fresh undead and 25 boomers. Okay. That one's just about done. Kill one each with the tomahawk use as a throwing weapon. So I gotta use the tomahawk, okay? I have to, okay. I know where I can get that. Yeah, that's to find one of the four horsemen of the apocalypse. Treasure maker, I have to find that guy yet.
Let's go!
I'm heading in the right direction for that.
From anyone groaning. Not again!
What are you doing?
God damn it! You claw at my back, I'll claw at yours. That's unfortunate. Oh, shit. This is something I don't want to think about. Well, that didn't go well.
Oh, I got chewing tobacco. Awesome. I didn't realize I had that. They give me 40 now. Wow.
Godforsaken shithole! Come on!
Alright, I'm gonna save this town and I'm gonna call it good here.
Poor dumb bastards! Yeah!
Well, I'm gonna get me and show you where I can get a shotgun and I call it quits there, because this would be insane. Yet.
Come on! More bastards! All of them! Whoa! Whoa there! just doing what I can.
Not bad.
Trying to eat me. That's unfortunate. This should put some undead to rest.
Oh, this is up top. That's right.
Thank you all very much. I'll be having that. Marshall?
Might have known you'd survive.
What's going on?
Do I look like I commune with the undead?
Well, no.
Well, then how would I know? My job is...
to take care of the folk who live here. Heard that one. How's that going?
How's that going? Well, let me put it to you this way. Cattle rustling and bank robbery are at an all-time low. But murder, blood drinking, and psychotic episodes seem to be somewhat prevalent. Either that, or I'm dreaming.
That's what I'm hoping, too.
How was it getting in here?
It was crazy.
Oh, they must be hiding again. They come in and then just disappear. Town's been nearly overrun a couple of times. Now we're low on ammunition, and I'm two men down.
I'll help you clear the place out if you like.
You're a good man, John Marston. But before that, I'm gonna need my deputies back.
What happened to them two clowns you had before? Gone?
Maybe. I sent Jonah off to look for Eli. They've both been gone for several hours now.
Who'd want to eat one of them?
That's a good question.
Where'd you send them?
Out near the general store. Jonah's got one of these new guns. I'm sure he can't run into any trouble. These things, they'd stop an elephant.
Thank you.
No, thank you. I'm sure you got your own troubles.
There's my new shotgun. Oh, it's not mine yet, but it will be. As soon as I do this mission.
Hey, mister.
Hey, Pard.
You seen a couple deputies nearby? Marshall's boys, Jonah and Eli.
Are they Jews, mister? They sound like Jews.
I don't know. Why?
Why? This whole thing is nothing but a Jewish plot. You do know that, don't you?
I find that highly unlikely, amigo.
Well, I don't like Jews. Or colored folk. Or natives, now that you mention it.
Well, you're a nice, kind-hearted man to meet in a time of trouble.
Kind does not come into it.
Why? What are you talking about?
Why? I bet you like Catholics. I can't stand them neither. Nor women. Fabians, socialists, homosexuals, Asians, or British. Between them, they ruined this country. Ruined it. It was a good country once. Now people are eating each other, and it's all the fault of the Jewish, British, Catholic, homosexual elite and their ideas. Well, I, for one, won't stand for it.
Have you ever met a Jewish person?
Thankfully not.
Or a British, Catholic, homosexual?
Not in my store. Oh, I get it. I see you acting clever. Well, let me tell you this. The Jews killed Lincoln. That's why there is a triangle on the money. And they run Europe like one of them Arabian harems. Now they've sent this here plague to kill all us decent folk. Yep.
You, sir, are truly a remarkable fella.
Thank you kindly.
I must say, it's a rare pleasure to meet someone with such a grasp on human history. You take care of yourself. I'd hate to see you get savaged by someone and watch the life force drain from your hate-filled body.
Hey, hold on there. Why don't you join me in my fight, sir? It's not too late.
I fear it is for me.
Then I will fight them alone. All of them. America is the land of the free. And that means free to people like me, Herbert Moon.
Absolutely.
No! You can't eat me! I'm Herbert!
on, boys? Marshall sent me and needs some help. Guess you got other plans. Seriously, enjoy your meal, no problem. Easy now, gentlemen. Remember all the fun times we had? I think I got my eye back. I miss the old times, fellas. I miss the fresh corpses. Marshall?
So, you find the boys?
I found them.
I understand. I hope it was fast for them.
It was fast. And they died with their bellies full. Well, one of them did.
Good.
That there's Jonah's gun.
Here, you keep it. After all, you earned it.
Thank you.
Take care of yourself, John.
You too, Marshal.
Here, save it, call it good, and on this episode, I hope you guys enjoyed it. In the next episode, we got this time to do, and there's gonna be more to do up in this area, that town, and where is it? There's a town over here somewhere I have to do. Right there. There. And there. And then we'll start on to this. And we'll go over here and do this. These are the main missions. But I want to clear out the towns and hope they don't get overrun again. So I'm going to call it good here. And I will see you in the next episode. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, subscribe.